Egypt's top Muslim cleric warns the country is on the brink of civil war. He's calling for the bloodshed in the streets to stop. This after 50 people died in clashes between Egypt's security forces and supporters of the ousted President Mohamed Morsi. Both sides in the conflict are blaming the other for starting it. Chris Mitchell reports from Cairo.
The military video shows some members firing on the soldiers.
We were assigned to secure the Republican Guard headquarters. And suddenly, early morning, we found motorcyclists firing at us, and some of us were hurt.
But the Muslim Brotherhood says the army planned the assault to break up their protest to reinstate Mohamed Morsi, and said they'd launch an intifada in response to the violence.
Whatever happened in Monday's clashes, some fear it might be just the first of many between the army and the Muslim Brotherhood. It's unlikely that Mohamed Morsi will ever be reinstated, and the Muslim Brotherhood will not give up its goals. But for most Egyptians, after just 1 year of rule under the Muslim Brotherhood, they saw a different future.
They saw a black future, I believe so. They saw the future of Afghanistan. They saw the future of Pakistan.
Freddie Benjamin is a leader in the Egyptian Social Democratic Party. He says the Muslim Brotherhood has its own agenda.
The Muslim Brotherhood, mainly, they are based on a very solid rock ideology, which is building the Islamic Caliphate. Okay? This is their main strategy and main target. It will never change. The tactics may change to achieve this goal, but the strategy will never change. They are intolerant. They only use democracy to kill democracy.
The Muslim Brotherhood began in 1928 and spawned most of today's major terror groups, including Al-Qaeda and Hamas. Benjamin says just 1 year rule under the Muslim Brotherhood sent 33 million Egyptians to the streets on June 30th, the biggest political protest in human history. He says that's why they want to send a message to the Obama administration, who they believe has supported the Muslim Brotherhood.
That brother Muslims are completely against democracy. They are against human rights, women rights. They don't believe in freedom of speech, freedom of belief, freedom of religion. They don't believe in all this. That's what I want. Yeah, that's what many Egyptian people want to convey this message to Obama administration.
Many Egyptians feel the overthrow of the Muslim Brotherhood is a key part of the global war on terror. Meanwhile, the White House says it will not cut off aid to Egypt. And here in Egypt, the interim government says new elections are planned for next year. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Cairo, Egypt.